two World Tag Team Champions against Harlem Heat for the belt. Iron Mike Tenay, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and Mike Tenay. In my mind, in the mind of many fans, Piper is the champion. He put him out, he put him to sleep, but there was one factor none of us expected, and that was the Macho Man Randy Savage last night.
Well, Tony, just when we think we have the answers, the New World Order changes the question.
Exactly.
I was convinced that the Macho Man Randy Savage had united with Sting against the New World Order until that shocking turn of events last night at Super Brawl.
That's a good point. We still don't know where Sting stands, but the fact is that Hogan still has the belt.
Well, the fact is Hogan's a very, very lucky man. He was almost put to sleep by Piper. Everyone saw that. I think he was out. I think the referee should have stopped the match and awarded him the title there, but that didn't happen. You're right about Sting. I don't know where he stands, but I think we all know pretty well where Savage stands.
Fans, if you joined us during hour number one, you saw some startling events. As a matter of fact, let's take you back to the footage now from hour number one where the Horsemen came out together. Surprisingly enough, it was Jeff Jarrett and Steve Mongo McMichael against Public Enemy. During the course of this match, Steve McMichael asked for the briefcase from Debra. We all thought he was going to hit Public Enemy, but then... ensued, but I think we can all realize what Ric Flair had to say. And what Flair had to say was, hey, the Horsemen are down. Benoit is now in the hospital. These two guys we're seeing right now, Mike, are the only two members of the Horsemen that can wrestle.
Well, I think it was a case of payback for Steve Mongo McMichael after last night at Super Brawl, but I think the four Horsemen all want to be on that same page, all looking for that solidarity. And we saw an interview at the conclusion of that matchup where Flair and Arn Anderson tried to get these two back together again with that handshake.
Okay, that was, fans, of course, in hour number one. In hour number two, off and running, still to come, the World Television Champion Prince Iaukea will be here. Dean Malenko, a man who got involved in the preceding match against the Ultimo Dragon. And as we said before, Harlem Heat against Lex Luger and the Giant in the second hour. Face Rey Mysterio Jr., two of the great athletes that we have seen over the past year from Mexico. And you must admit, Mike, they have really been a factor and a force. And it's been great for the fans to see these superstars from Mexico here.
Well, these two intense rivals from south of the border bring this great feud to WCW. And just the addition of all the stars from Mexico has really added to the talent depth, the talent roster here at World Championship Wrestling. And that's what keeps this organization number one.
He's been pretty well banged up lately, but he keeps coming out. He gives 100%. He comes off that top rope, second, third rope, and there were 20 ropes he came off him.
Well, we received last night he was able to adapt. With that recent knee injury, he may not have all of the incredible high-risk moves that he's had before, but he's really picked it up with a great mat technique, great mat game, and he's going to need both the high-risk moves and the mat game against Juventud Guerrera.
I think many people were shocked, and this is certainly not a slight on the television champ, Prince Iaukea, but shocked that Mysterio did not come away with the belt because he certainly has more ring time than Prince Iaukea does. But the fact is, and we're going to show the fans a little bit later on, that Lord Steven Regal got involved in that match. And I'm going to say the same thing as I said last night. I think Regal did that because he feels, Regal, that he can defeat Iaukea and not Rey Mysterio Jr.
You really think he thinks he can't defeat Rey Mysterio Jr.?
No question about that.
Well, he's mad because Mysterio cost him the title. He came up that aisle and stuck his nose where it didn't belong. Look at this.
It was a case of sour grapes, in my opinion, on the part of Regal last night, preventing Rey Mysterio Jr. Oh, spiked him with the DDT.
How about that move by Juventud Guerrera now? Waiting on Mysterio to get up. Great sense of anticipation there.
Oh, tremendous maneuver.
You know, no one uses the ropes for added leverage or added spring, as you say, Mike, a springboard, than these athletes from south of the border. They live up there.
Well, that's why a knee injury to Rey Mysterio Jr. at this point in his career really limits what he can do offensively. But as we saw last night at Super Brawl against Prince Iaukea, he was still able to come up with a tremendous performance, the most resilient performer in WCW today.
No, I think what they got going on their side more than anything is the conditioning they're in and their youth.
Absolutely. 22 years old for Rey Mysterio Jr., 21 for Juventud Guerrera, which translates appropriately enough to youth warrior.
One, you got shorts that old.
Well, maybe I do.
Maybe you don't.
And up to the top again. Not only that, they're so young, but they've been wrestling many, many years, Mike.
Well, 8 years almost now for Ray Jr. and Juventud Guerrera in his fifth.
Wow. A chop now. Into the midsection.
You know, they really adapt to WCW style of wrestling. Plus, they keep their Mexican style of wrestling, too.
Yeah, I think it makes them so dangerous. I think a good wrestler will always use his style to try to win matches, regardless of what the opponent will do. We've seen that so many times in so many matches. Here's a cover. One, two. What they have done, basically, these great Mexican wrestlers, they have made this cruiserweight division one of the top divisions in the world. Dean Malenko, of course, still the top contender. Six is the cruiserweight champion, but Dean Malenko's not thinking about six right now. That's apparent. He's thinking about Eddie Guerrero. Up on top, over the top, and to the apron on the outside.
We talked about Mysterio's dominance in the cruiserweight ranks. That would have been so important last week, getting a win and gaining that world heavyweight TV title. Great moonsault.
One, two on the moonsault, and Mysterio almost got caught.
You know, it's very dangerous doing those high-risk moves wearing a mask. They could turn a half an inch, a half a fraction of an inch, and you miss your mark where you're going to land. You think your opponent's laying in one spot? Next minute, you can be on the cement floor, the stamp.
And, of course, your peripheral vision is always limited when you wear the mask. And if the mask would happen to slip also, that obviously could cause problems with those high-risk moves.
And you should know, I've seen a lot of magazines when your picture's in it with a mask on.
That's not a mask. Never
back
mind. To the corner. Into the missed a clothesline that time. Up on top.
No!
Look at that spectacular move. That is great balance. That's all that is.
It's like wrestling a helicopter.
Here he comes again. Tried the baseball slide.
Well, we've seen that baseball slide many times, but to end up with that kind of a move on the tail end, incredible.
Was that Juventud Rose?
Oh, and Mysterio, you can see his back is hurting, and he tries to go back to the point of attack again, but very slow to get there. I agree with that.
Movie's hurt.
That's the first time I've seen a baseball slide executed like that.
They do so many things, you know, and you can watch him. You can watch 100 of their matches. They do 100 different things every different time.
Oh, my.
Oh! Power bombed him down.
There's his neck.
One, two. Mysterio gets out.
Incredible balance and agility by both men on the top rope.
And he landed right on the back of his neck.
You know, and we said this last night, if there's one thing opponents need to learn about Rey Mysterio Jr., and that is he's not down until the three count. The man just will not give up. He is so resilient. All right, here comes Juventud. Suicide dive. He connected that time in the back of Rey Mysterio to the safety rail.
Well, he's signaling he's going to do something. It won't be nice for Rey Mysterio, I bet that.
What else could he do? I mean, they have revolutionized our sport in many ways with their moves, and he's going to try something else. Up on top, springboard.
What a reversal by Ray.
He powerbombed him out of it.
But he didn't go for the pin. He should have gone for the pin here.
He's going to try something up top as well.
No kidding, Sherlock.
Mysterio again. This time he connects. One, two, three.
Moving to a solid and half like an envelope.
You know, that was almost, well, it was the same move. Moving to
Dark Eagle.
And Rey Mysterio Jr. able to execute it.
I'm feeling a lot better.
To get the win.
And I want that belt. Even though you're not going to have it. Not even one bit. It's going to be mine. You're going to come after me. Let's see if you can catch me.
Juventud's attempt at the springboard Huracan Rana was turned into a powerbomb by Rey Jr. And he beat him with his own move.
That's the insulting part.